Hey everyone, it's Lisa, and today I would love to talk to you and share with you the many reasons women are coming to carnivore. Many of you sent me the video where Tati here on YouTube, Glam Life Guru, that's a tongue twister, she did a video the other day on how she's been eating and her new lifestyle, how she has healed her gut, how she has just changed her life. Like I have always told you guys, carnivore has done for me. I believe she said that she does not consider herself full-blown carnivore because she still eats fruit. Well, that is very common in the carnivore community to still eat fruit, mainly berries, but I think she said that she was eating some other fruits maybe in the morning. But there were just so many things that she talked about that we have in common as women. And then there are some other things that I thought I would bring to your attention. And of course, I will link that video down below. You can have the most expensive outfit, designer. You can have the most expensive designer Chanel bag. You can have the best makeup and the best hair. If you don't feel good physically, it really affects how you feel mentally. And I never knew that until I healed my gut and I worked on my issues. Now I can feel just as good or better in a Walmart outfit with Walmart shoes, a Walmart bag, and Walmart makeup. So I've walked the walk. I know what I'm talking about as far as she was saying how it has just like lifted a cloud off of her head. So I thought I would go through some issues that I think are very geared towards women and really a reason that so many women are coming to the carnivore or meat-based diet, because it's never been like a really feminine vibe diet. You know, even if you look up carnivore diet on YouTube, you will see a bunch of beefy men holding up steaks. I will say it's gotten better since I started, because I've been doing this a little over probably 2.5 years. The first reason I think a lot of women come to the carnivore diet is because of gut issues. We all know how prevalent IBS is. We know that it's more prevalent in women, and it's probably less talked about because it's not something that a woman wants to talk about. And Tati was talking about going to like events and things like that, and she doesn't drink, I don't drink. I know exactly what she's talking about. When you are sitting there in a room full of people or a table full of people and they're drinking and they're having a good time and they're eating and you're not doing either one, it makes you feel out of place. It automatically, without you even knowing it, and because I have done the exact same conference now 3 times, 2 times before I got better and went on carnivore, and then this last time I just went, which I do have a video coming up on how I ate and how I stayed on the carnivore diet during that week, but now that I have experienced them both, I realize what a difference it makes in your psyche, in your attitude, even how you see others, how you perceive the whole event is so different when you are able to eat and when you're able to feel confident in the way that you feel and the way that you're living. And I could tell by watching Tati's video that she is almost there, but I can tell she's just still a little bit hesitant to say she doesn't want to eat vegetables. And I understand that. It took me a long time. It really took me until I had many lab panels done, which I will put a video up here. It took me being confident in what I was doing and how I was eating, because I did not want to tell you guys something that was wrong. So if you are a woman that is experiencing bloating, gas, IBS, really think about trying the meat-based carnivore diet, because nothing will heal your gut more than this diet. I have just experienced it, and it will change your life. Another thing she mentioned is the gut-brain connection. I have talked to you guys about this before, how I was amazed. There is a book, I believe it's called The Brain-Gut Connection. I can see it. I can see the cover of it right now, but I will link it below. That is a fabulous book. And when I even just watch videos on that, I had no idea there are actual receptors like are in the brain in our gut, and they are sending messages back and forth. So if your gut is not good, if your gut is upset, then your brain is going to be upset. I never knew until I experienced it. And honestly, I could not believe it. I could not believe the results I was getting that went past just me having the IBS issues and the bloating. It really blew my mind. So that is something I think that brings a lot of women to carnivore, is just that feeling of getting your gut in check. Takes the cloud away. It makes you think so clearly. It makes you realize what's important. It helps you appreciate life. It gives you more energy. I mean, like she said that she used to have to take a nap every day after she did her video. Me too. I would take a nap every day because I was exhausted. So I think that's another reason women would appreciate carnivore, is the energy factor. It really gives you more energy, more clarity, less depression. And if you will, just look up the carnivore diet and depression, bipolar, schizophrenia, Alzheimer's. Look up, just Google that and look at the connections that they've made with all of these things that have a lot to do with inflammation in the brain. It is astounding. I listen to podcasts all the time, and it gets you to the point where you just want to tell the world. And you can't understand why everyone isn't doing this, but then I realize it's not the easiest transition. Okay, the next, and I think one of the biggest reasons that women are coming to carnivore, and that is hormones. Now, Tati is 40, so she is 12 years younger than I am. She is getting to that age where when you hit 40, I think it happened to me like 43, I always knew my mom went through menopause at 45, so I knew it was coming. Things are not the same. Your body starts to change. Your mind starts to change. Things aren't as clear. Even for me, it was things like my balance. It was just some crazy things. And the more these crazy things happen, the more depressed you get. So with hormones, when you do the carnivore diet, it will regulate your hormones. There are women that have been infertile and, you know, did, I think Dr. Barry's wife, I think they did IVF to have their first baby, and then she got pregnant with her second baby after being on ketovore. And when you get your hormones in check, then that just branches out to so many other things, like women my age, like bone density and mood, energy, sleep. I mean, we know that hormones pretty much rule the body. So that is another reason that I think women are thriving on the carnivore diet. And then I would go probably to the next thing would be weight. And I think a lot of women, you know, of course we get to the point where we're gaining weight and, you know, but if you're like me, I kind of thought, you know, I'm in my 40s. My hormones are whacked out. I'm just going to gain weight and there's going to be nothing I can do about it. Well, to my surprise, when I got my gut in check and I got on the carnivore diet and I got all of that crazy insulin spikes and everything under control, then I started losing weight. I lost all of that extra just flabby weight that is, you know, around your muscles, on your gut. I also lost the water weight, and I think that is one of the main complaints that women have, is that weight around their middle and the water weight and the bloating. I know Tati talked about after she ate how her stomach would blow up. So it's so refreshing when you start this diet to get rid of all of that bloating, all of that water weight. And I will say this too, now that I eat this way, I don't even have the air. Like I don't have the gas, I'll put it that way. I don't have to burp. I don't, you know, none of that. I'm not taking Tums, Prilosec. I'm not taking Pepto-Bismol. I had a whole little package of different things, Alka-Seltzers. Pepto was my favorite. But I feel like, you know, as a woman, these things happen to us over time. And I'm sure it's hormonal and it's society. You know, we're eating all of the wrong things. But when you do the carnivore diet and you start eating like this, it will help you feel like you used to feel. And you will have forgotten what it even feels like to feel good. That's why I always say, I don't think I felt this good in my 20s. I probably did, but I probably didn't appreciate it because I was bogged down with all that silly stuff. So when you get to be my age and your mind is sharp and clear, and you have come to grips with what's really important to you, what really matters in your life, and then you put that with feeling good, it is very powerful. That is when you make things happen in your life. That is when you level up. That is when you make your life what you have dreamed of, because you feel powerful, you don't feel helpless, you have clear sight of what it is you want, what it is you value most, and you will feel unstoppable. And then another thing that I think women have issues with, and I know that I did, and this is just a little thing, but I think it's very important to a lot of women, and I think it scares women, you know, to not even want to try the carnivore diet, is they cannot imagine not ever eating snacks and sugar. And the number one question I get is about cravings. What keeps you from craving that sugar or that little bit of chocolate at night like I used to eat? I had gotten to the point where I would not even fool myself. If I went to a restaurant and I was only a little bit hungry, but I knew I wanted the dessert, I would just skip the dinner and eat my dessert while the kids and John were eating dinner, or maybe eat some of the appetizer and then eat the dessert. So I know all about cravings, but cravings, they actually come with that whole cycle of eating something and then it giving you that big like dopamine and serotonin rush to your brain. You know, you get that rush and then it doesn't last very long. And then what happens? You crash. I know when I was at the conference, I was standing there waiting for one of my little round table events, and I looked at the snacks that they had out on the table for all of the girls to eat, and it was like an ice cream bar. I joked with all of them. I was like, you need some yogurt or some ice cream, because it was all of these toppings that they were loading into a cup and eating. And I knew what it would make them feel like. It would immediately make them feel kind of good and give them a little bit of energy, but they were all going to need a nap in the afternoon. It's going to make them crash. Where I, eating nothing but meat and eggs, was an even keel all day. There was no up and down. It was the same good energy from the time I woke up to the time I went to bed. And I just want to tell each and every one of them, don't do that, don't do that. But I know it's something that you have to experience. And I know it's an age thing too. I think that younger girls can probably handle it a little bit better than when you get in your late 30s and 40s. You will start noticing those differences. And then the last thing I want to touch on is skin and hair. Skin, hair, nails, gums, everything. It just makes your skin glow. You will have that natural moisture, that natural glow to your skin. It gets rid of like rosacea. I don't know this personally, but if you will Google the carnivore diet with rosacea, psoriasis, eczema, it has performed miracles. And I've probably seen more men show like how their legs are just covered in eczema or psoriasis, and then they start the carnivore diet and you can just see it going away. How would that feel? I feel like it's made my teeth and my gums better. I feel like it has just my hair definitely be better. It's just amazing for your hair. And I think Tati even mentioned that she felt like her skin looked better, that she didn't have any breakouts on her back. It's amazing. It's amazing. I remember when I was going through menopause, remember how my chest was breaking out all the time? You guys, I could just go on and on. Another thing I noticed this past summer is not burning in the sun. I mean, not getting any sunburn, which I do wear some amounts of sunscreen, but used to in the past, I would like burn in different splotches and everything. That is something I think you will have to Google and, you know, read for yourself, because I'm not a doctor, like Tati said. I think both of us, we don't want to lead you into something that, you know, may not be good for you. So I do think it's always good to run it by your doctor. I know I did mine, and that's why he checked my blood panels and my labs every 4 months, for a year, to just see how it was going to affect me. And he looked at me and said, are you telling everybody? Are you telling your audience what this has done for you? I was able to get off of iron. Now that I have lived it for 2.5 years, I feel confident. Of course I don't feel like your doctor, and I don't want you to do anything that is going to hurt you. So if you have any reasons that you think you should not do this, I know it's supposed to be good for thyroid issues, but I still recommend you talking to your doctor. The bad thing is, I hope you have an open-minded doctor that has read up on this. If you don't, take some research with you. Don't tell him that Lisa D1 told you. Take some research with you and, you know, be your best advocate. It takes a lot. I mean, I'm someone who still tries to believe everything that a doctor said. But after they told me all of these crazy things to do and it didn't work, you know, there comes a point where you have to try things for yourself. So even if you try the carnivore diet for, just tell yourself, okay, I'm going to do this for a week. Never tell yourself I'm not going to eat candy for the rest of my life. Do it a week at a time. And if you want to, try to add things in and see what upsets your stomach. I have many videos on that. And, you know, don't feel like your path has to be the same as someone else's. The way we come to carnivore, especially as women, is so different. I mean, look at Tati. She comes from a very, you know, all natural. I mean, she's been vegan. She's done all of these things. She comes from a California type point of view, a younger generation. I come from a meat-based, you know, very traditional Southern family. So eating meat was not that foreign to me. She probably came to this through, I know she has endometriosis and she was taking hormones to try to get pregnant. So she has that aspect. So that's one of the reasons I was so excited to see her talk about this and hear what she said, because I think that she is going to reach so many more people than I probably will, and a younger generation. You know, I've told you, I think I did a video that, you know, the word carnivore isn't sexy. It's hard to even say it sometimes. I know sometimes I have even said a zero carb diet, and then the person will start going through, well, can you eat this? Can you eat this? It's hard. It's hard to wrap your brain around, and it takes you being confident in what you're doing and what you're saying. So I applaud Tati for talking about it. I'm so happy, and I'm connecting with many more carnivore women that hopefully I will connect you guys with too. I think I'm going to end this here, even though I could go on and on forever. And I will, because that's how strongly I feel about it. I feel like I have been called to do this. Just like everything else I like to do with women, I want to empower you. I have a love for other women. I always want to share. And I think that you guys saw the way my life was changing even before I decided to share everything with you. It just really fulfills me and just enhances my life when you guys tell me that you started this when I did, or you started this because I was talking about it, and you have lost 30 pounds and you feel the best you've ever felt. I have people send me pictures of their before and after, and it's amazing. It's amazing how much prettier women look because you're happy. That sadness is gone from your eyes. You're vibrant. Your skin is glowing. Not to mention, like Tati said, with her muscles and how she feels in her body, you will start to feel strong. It will not take you going to a gym 7 days a week, working out for an hour. Oh my gosh, I don't even have time to get into that. But it breaks my heart when I see women that are obese and really need to lose weight for their health, and they are starving themselves, restricting, you know, calories, and sweating and just suffering at the gym, when really this is a much better way to come to a lean, healthy body. You are putting in your body what you're supposed to eat, what your body is used to. It thrives. And, you know, I work out like 10 minutes a night, you guys, and I feel like I am more toned and more in shape than I was when I was doing all kinds of crazy stuff at the gym. And my trainer had me do the craziest, most embarrassing things all over that gym, and I did not look like I do today. Okay, I'm gonna have to stop here. I'm going to put in a video of this dress and belt that I'm wearing. It is a dress that I purchased for the conference that I just went to and I did not end up wearing, but I think it is a fabulous dress and it was not very expensive. I think you can change up the belt. You could put a chain belt with this. You could put your Gucci belt. You could put any type of belt with this, wide or like mine or thin. Really change up the look. You could put boots with it, change your shoes, and or whatever kind of faux fur jacket or moto jacket. I just think it's a very versatile dress. And I love a good, you know, I love off the shoulder. I love one shoulder. But yet, it's pretty conservative to be a one shoulder dress. So I think that you guys would like this. I hate that I didn't get to wear it. I just can't wait to go to my next event. You know, I'm just loving it. Carnivore has made it where I look forward to things like that in my life. I am excited for every day. And that's the way I want you guys to feel too. So thank you for watching. Thank you, Tati, for inspiring this video. Thank you to you guys for sending that video to me because it might have been a while until I got to it to watch it. So thank you, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.